premiere of Chuck Steele, Night of the Trampires, getting ready to go in and watch the film. I've got Ty with me, right? How come you got here so early? You're always late to everything. Yeah? There's no free food in that.
What do you mean I'm okay?
Thank you, yes.
Hey!
You look like a Bond girl.
Oh, is it? Someone else said that. I'll take it.
Like a Bond girl, isn't it? Yeah, I mean, this ain't a Bond movie. This is Night, you know, Chuck Steele, Night of the Trampires.
I don't know what the vibe is, so I thought I'll just go with this look.
It's like this thing called stop motion. Yeah. So you know like that thing Wallace and Gromit?
Pingu? Like Pingu, you remember Pingu?
Pingu. I'm here with an absolute legend, Biff from the group Saxon.
Now, be here.
And of course, you guys feature in the film, you got music in the film, and it suits the film because this is an all-action, high-octane film.
It is, and it's sort of set in, I think it's set in 1985, 86, so they chose one of our songs from that period. So it's not such a metal song, it's just a heavy rock song.
Killing is horror, it's mad, it's a mad film.
It was just more of an action thing, and it's more of an adult action where it's a bit of...
horror, it's madness.
Yeah, this sounds nuts then.
It's chaos.
I'm looking forward to it now you're saying this. I hope you're not gassing me.
Enjoy it.
What the fuck was that?
This one ain't for the kids. Yeah.
Oh my god.
So many parts in the film where I like did not see like certain types of comedy coming.
The humour in it, the adult humour, is what makes the film in it.
Yeah, a lot of people loving the humour in the film as well.
Well, I'm glad because I've always been nervous of what the reaction to, you know, the jokes and all of that stuff in there because some of it's pretty edgy and weird.
Loose change in my foreskin.
Wow.
Something totally different, eh?
It was crazy, I ain't gonna lie, it was crazy, mad, like a lot going on.
Obviously, the main character is based on 80s film characters and all that.
Still! Do you have any idea how much damage you cause?
More than a little, but less than a lot.
I saw a few different elements of films that I like. I think Team America, I saw a bit of Spitting Image in there.
I didn't even think Spitting Image,
which was one of my favourite. And the third one, which again is the gory part, is A Walking Dead.
I'm a lover of action movies.
That's actually got a lot of action.
When we say gunshot, we say yo, from start to end.
It was like, it started here, went here, and ended here. It was like high tempo throughout.
Can't wait till it comes out. We'll watch it again, but you know me, blood. I'm gonna watch that at home with a fat one, blood. I'm gonna roll me around this back, blood. And I'm telling you, me and Chuck Steele will go again for part two, blood.
I'm here with the director of the movie, Chuck Steele and the Trampires, Mike Moore. Mike, everybody is like, you know, raving about this film. It's completely different to anything we've ever seen before. How did you come up with the idea for this film?
I came up with this character when I was 15 years old. So I used to draw him in my school books and make Super 8 movies in my parents' garage, you know, growing up. And also I made some college films with the character. So he was always with me through my career in animation as a character that I wanted to revisit. So I was trying over the years to raise money for it and make a feature film a number of times, but it's taken this long to actually get it done. It's a weird film and an out there film, so you know, it's hard to raise the money for those types of things, but we did it eventually after years.
Describe the film to us. Describe the type of film it is.
Well, it's a stop motion animated film featuring Chuck Steele, who is your sort of archetypal maverick cop on the edge, who was all the rage back in the 80s. This film is set in the 80s, and the style of it is very much like the 80s movies that I grew up with, like, you know, Die Hard and Steven Seagal movies, and movies like Fright Night, horror films like that, yeah. Return of the Living Dead. So those fun films that I grew up with, I kind of, it's all in a blender, this film, and there's a lot of references in there for people who's familiar with those movies. But this is a story of this guy being an idiot, mostly, but still somehow managing to, save the day. And there's lots of monsters in it as well.
The brilliant thing about it is the animation, the stop motion, like you said. I was learning how long it takes, and I couldn't believe it. Explain to us how long it takes.
Yeah, for one second of screen time, you have to move the character 24 times. So wow. It's tiny incremental moves to do things, but a second of screen time is 24 frames. And we didn't have any CGI characters in this film. It was all puppets. So there's crowd scenes at the end where there's hundreds of characters running around. There's one shot which took 2 months to shoot, and it lasts for about a second because there's so many characters running around.
2 months to shoot and it lasts in 1 second.
Yeah, it's lunacy. It makes no sense.
And the car scene in it, which is my favourite part of the movie, the car chase, absolutely insane. How long did that take to shoot?
Well, that was 5 minutes of screen time, and that took probably the entire length of the shoot, which was about 3 years to shoot around 5 minutes of animation, yeah. Because it was very, very intricate, small. We had different scales of puppets, so the car chase was like 1/18 scale, like your toy cars, and then our puppets are like 1/6 scale, so this is a bigger one. But then we'd have large scale hands for close-up that are close to human-sized hands. So there's three scales of model in the movie.
Man, you never think that in watching it.
Yeah.
It's absolutely incredible. I mean, the patience you've got to have to do a film like this. 2 months. Yeah. Listen, 2 hours for me, I'll be going insane.
Yeah.
2 months.
Well, we had one animator on that, Paul Thomas, who was just locked in this one unit for 2 months, making characters run around. There was about, 200 of them. So it's insane. But
you've got to be a special kind of guy to do.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, he special kind of patience.
He didn't crack up, thankfully, so we didn't break him.
Well, it's out now, and yep. You're looking forward to everybody, watching it up and down the country.
Yeah, I'm really, really hoping that people connect with it and enjoy it for what it is. In my eyes, it's 86 minutes of lunacy, and fun. It's an intense film, but it's ridiculous. And I hope people can just have a laugh with it, really, because, that's my kind of film.
Well, listen, it's a great film. I want to congratulate you. Well done. Well done for your patience. And everybody check out the film. Chuck Steele and the Trampires. It's crazy. It's brilliant, the animations, the stop motions. I highly recommend it. It will be a night of fun. Trust me. Make sure you check it out.
Chuck Steele, Night of the Trampires.